if you had a dinner party, who would be your three dream guests? And then what would you rustle up in the kitchen for them?
Oh my goodness, I would say David Bowie, Anne Boleyn, weirdly, always had a strange fascination with her. And, oh gosh, for right now, I'm going to say Stevie Nicks, for right now.
Amazing.
And in terms of me cooking, I wouldn't, because they would die. So I am going to do, some delivery, some takeaway, and everyone will actually enjoy their meals.
So. Three dinner guests. I want a comedian. I want like a writer and a musical artist of some sort. Like I couldn't be more specific, but then it's like, because then I feel like you've got a good conversation, people, and then entertainment, and like, I don't want to be cooking for chefs. I haven't really answered your question. I'm making a lemon meringue pie as dessert. I'm making some sort of pasta.
Obama, John Lennon. Tricky one. Who's the third one? Somebody really funny. I'll go Marilyn Monroe just to mix it up, actually. Yeah.
What are you going to be cooking then? What can you rustle up in the kitchen?
Cornish pasties.
Cornish pasties. Fabulous. Mark, thank you so much.
Probably David Robinson, who's a basketball player from the 90s from the San Antonio Spurs, only because I loved him growing up. I would say maybe Kubrick, because I would love to have a meal with him. And then I would love to do dinner with like Sarah Silverman.
Oh.
Yeah, I would love to bring her into the mix.
Yes.
Yeah.
And what are you cooking them then?
And then I'm cooking them, honestly, just down and dirty tacos.
Oh. What is the most extravagant meal that you've actually had in real life?
Anything with truffles on it. It's just so good. It's every time I see truffles on a menu, I'm like, the choice has been made for me. Like,
for prep for this, I went to the Fat Duck, which was quite extraordinary. Like, the stuff they were doing in there, the food was amazing. And it was like a whole experience.
I used to work on Game of Thrones, and the writers were quite big foodies, so I'd always hit them up for some fancy meal whenever we went on location. We went to this grill place in north of Spain, which I still salivate just thinking about. It was pretty good.
I went to a downtown, like a museum in Los Angeles, and it was performance art with the meal. And so it was extravagant in the sense that everything that you were like seeing and absorbing was also something that was sort of like reflected in the food. So that was extravagant. But yeah, I think gun to my head, I'm probably doing the cheeseburger.
Did you get to eat a lot on set of like delicious?
I ate tons. There was one day where I just ate bread the whole day. I didn't eat anything but bread.
Well, that sounds like my heaven actually. So can we sort of...
This bread was quite chewy.
Dense. What was it like working with Ralph Fiennes? He's a very formidable character. You know, while the camera cuts, is he cracking a few jokes on set? What was that relationship like between you and your fellow castmates?
You know, we all had such a good time because the camera was constantly roving around all the different tables. So we were all on all the time. But it's funny when people say that Rafe is formidable because, of course, you know, that's the he's definitely got a presence. But I just feel a lot of comfort when thinking about Rafe. We had such a lovely, warm camaraderie between the two of us. And I think we had a real affinity for each other. And hopefully you can see that on screen. So I loved any of our one-on-one scenes.